When you buy a car, you discover that there are a lot of acronyms that you might not be familiar with. You may be considering TC as one such abbreviation. Is TC on an automobile significant? What does it mean? We assess the meaning and functionality of TC in this video. We also search for indications that the TC system isn't functioning properly. What does TC mean in a car? In a vehicle, TC represents traction control. When driving on low traction surfaces, this automotive system helps with acceleration while preventing wheels from slipping or overspinning. This is a useful safety feature found in the majority of contemporary cars. Any driving condition can be made smooth with the help of the traction control system. It aids in maintaining stability while accelerating, even on slick roads, like those that have been driven on after a downpour. With the aid of the speed sensors, the traction control system determines the issue when one wheel spins more quickly than the others. When the wheel starts to spin, the car will automatically change its speed to allow it to regain contact with the road. In the event that applying the brakes is necessary, the ECU may also turn on the ABS and lessen engine torque. To alert you to the slippage, the traction control light may occasionally illuminate on the dashboard. If the light turns off again right away, the system is working properly. But if the light remains on, there might be a malfunction in the system. When to use the TC. Even when the roads are clear, you can always keep the traction control system engaged. It does not require your action to turn on because it is activated automatically when the car starts. Although it is manually reversible, there are specific circumstances in which you should make sure it is turned on. In the event of inclement weather, such as snow, ice, or intense rain, you should activate the traction control system. When driving on damp or slick roads, you'll want the extra assistance. Additionally, it comes in handy when navigating a winding or curving road. You don't want to lose momentum when making a turn. This is particularly crucial in the event that the road surfaces are muddy or wet. When to turn off traction control. For the majority of the time you are driving, the traction control system ought to be engaged. However, there are a few uncommon situations in which turning it off might be preferable. For instance, you might want to turn off the car if it gets stuck in mud, sand, or snow. With traction control engaged, escaping these circumstances while the wheels are spinning may be more difficult. In these circumstances, you want the wheels to spin in order for them to find firm ground by sinking into the ice, sand, mud, or snow. You can regain traction and remove the car once the wheel touches this ground. Traction control would also be your enemy if you intended to race your car or engage in drifting. Rather, you want the wheels to spin as coolly as possible. Why is traction control warning light on? Poor road conditions. Should you encounter a patch of ice on the road, the TC light may momentarily illuminate. You are being informed by this warning light that the traction control system has been engaged. Nevertheless, as soon as traction is restored, the light ought to turn off. If not, there might be a more serious issue. Bad wheel speed sensors. Wheel sensors are required in order to determine the speed at which each is moving. The traction control system is kept informed by the connections between each of these sensors and the ECU. When a sensor malfunctions, the ECU receives inaccurate signals from the faulty sensor. This issue causes the traction control light to illuminate until the malfunctioning wheel speed sensor is replaced. A wheel speed sensor replacement could run you between $325 and $400. While the part may cost $250 to $300, labor should only account for $75 to $100. Faulty steering angle sensor. The steering wheel's angle is being closely observed by the traction control system. The steering wheel's rotational speed while driving is also reported by the sensor. Should there be an issue with this sensor, a replacement is required. When the sensor fails, the traction control light illuminates. If you would like to try changing it yourself, you can find it in the steering column. A steering angle sensor replacement could run you anywhere from $125 to $500. While the sensor itself may cost $50 to $250, labor may cost $75 to $250. ABS malfunction. The traction control system and the anti-lock braking system are complementary. Many of the same sensors and parts are used in the operation of these parts. This means that the traction control light may illuminate in addition to the ABS light in the event of a malfunction. Use your code scanner to find the defective part and determine the cause.